Hey guys, it's John with Ideaform 3D, and today I'm going to show you how I used RealityCapture's pay-per-input licensing to create a custom dust-collecting adapter between my miter saw and my shop vac. So the first step was to just inspect the job and try to figure out how I'm going to adapt the shop vac to the miter saw. After that, I took some really accurate measurements using some digital calipers just to figure out exactly what measurements I'm dealing with. The next step was to identify the area of interest where I wanted all my focus of the photogrammetry. I put the miter saw in a well even lit area in my garage, and I took increment shots in a sweeping fashion, kind of like this diagram. I then did a higher angle and did the same thing where I would take pictures in a circular sweeping motion around the miter saw. So after that, I visited capturingreality.com where you can download Reality Capture for free, and using the pay-per-input licensing, you can learn the software for free and kind of learn about photogrammetry and the workflow for free. And then once you're happy with the result, you can pay to export it. So the basic workflow for Reality Capture, once you have it installed, you just start it up. And I'm going to navigate to that folder where I have all of the photos that I took of the miter saw. So I'm going to select all of these photos, and I'm just going to drag them into my workspace right here, my project. And once they're all loaded in, there's a lot of settings down here that you can change in regard to the alignment. But I'm going to hop over into the alignment tab up here, and just using the default settings, I'm going to hit align images. All right, so the alignment just finished, and I don't think it took more than 30 seconds to align all the images, which is really fast compared to the competitors. So it kind of left us with, you see all of these little dots up here, and these are actually where that photo was taken. This is all the camera ticks. And then there's kind of this big bounding box, and then all of these points. So all of these points are your initial point cloud to try to let the user understand where you are in 3D space. So I can see that our miter saw is right here. And what I'm gonna do with this bounding box is I'm gonna click on these different colored circles. And what this is gonna do is this is gonna crop the area that we wanna work with. So let's move this up and let's kind of just align this box so it's just around that miter saw point cloud right here. So the next step, after we've defined the bounding area around the saw, I'm gonna hop into the next tab, which is Reconstruction, and I'm just gonna click the normal detail, and this is gonna calculate the lower res, the normal 3D model, using all of our cameras and this bounding box. So let's hit normal detail. All right guys, Reality Capture finished creating the normal detail 3D model, and it looks really nice. We're most interested in this area to create the adapter, so all the details in here look really good, and it'll work great as a reference for creating this adapter. So you also have the option to create a higher detail 3D model by hitting this high detail button up here. And you can also texture the 3D model by hitting unwrap, which will create texture coordinates. And then when you hit texture, it'll actually texture this 3D model. Once I'm happy with the 3D model and I want to export it using the PPI licensing, I'll sign into my account. And once I'm signed in, Reality Capture is going to ask about what type of activation I want to use, and I'll hit the PPI pay per input pay when satisfied. And what this does is this activates the software for free, so I can use the software for free, and then once I'm happy with the result, I can export it using my PPI credits. So once I'm logged in and I've paid for credits, I can hit go up here to export model, and I'm going to export this as miter saw, and using the PPI credits, I'm going to export this as an OBJ. And what's nice about this is it'll export the texture and all the other work that you did in Reality Capture. And I'm gonna hit okay. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial on Reality Capture and learned a few things along the way. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and support me by visiting my website at ideaform3d.com. Thanks again, have a good day.